A Twitter from the Atlantic by Barrie Mahoney. A tortoise called Aduana. Despite all the positive aspects of living in the Canary Islands, there are, as in all things in life, a few negatives too. One of my main irritations is slow delivery of parcels, which is often due to the Aduana customs process. Even though the Canary Islands are part of Spain and within the European Union, we're outside both for the purposes of taxation. This state of affairs is of great benefit to residents and visitors alike, who can buy all the luxury goods that they can afford whilst on holiday and pay only 5% IGIC, which is the local tax, instead of IVA or VAT in Spain of 18% and in the UK of 20%. However, there are downsides too. If, for example, I wish to purchase an item from outside the Canary Islands, I invariably end up paying the tax from the country of origin, as well as the local Canary Islands tax, plus a delivery surcharge of around €6. Fortunately, those very good people at Amazon have now seen the error of their ways after I challenged them recently. I was surprised and delighted to receive a hefty refund for all the VAT that I've paid them on items delivered to the Canary Islands over the last few years. Yes, if you contact them after delivery, they will refund your VAT if you live in the Canary Islands. Now back to the Aduana. This organisation does seem to move at a pace of a tortoise on Prozac. They appear to be totally unaware that we have a global economy nowadays and that many of us like to shop globally. After all, there are some things that cannot be purchased in the Canary Islands. Take, for example, Amazon's very clever new device, the Kindle e-reader. Now, I do confess to having some interest in the success of this product, as I have several publications in this format. However, if you live in Spain and the Canary Islands, the only option is to purchase the Kindle from Amazon.com in the USA. On the face of it, this is not a problem. Ordering from Amazon.com is quick and simple, apart from having to deposit an additional sum for local tax to be paid to the Aduana upon arrival. The tracking information was fascinating. My Kindle left Kentucky in the US and arrived in Germany the following day. The package arrived in Madrid the next day. I was in Las Palmas the day after that. Now, I think that 4 days for a package to get from the US to the Canary Islands is really rather good. However, as I write this, my box of goodies has been sitting in the office of the Aduana in Las Palmas awaiting release. 4 days so far and still counting. 2 months ago, my publishers in the UK sent me a box containing copies of my new book, Letters from the Atlantic. 1 month later, I was still waiting for the box to arrive when I received a telephone call. The publishers had just received the box of books back in their offices, undelivered. Undaunted, they tried again. 3 weeks later, the same thing happened, and the box was returned to them. No reason given, just returned. We send all over the world, even Oman, despite the recent troubles, and the books always get there. It's always the Canary Islands that are the problem, commented one irritated member of staff. The whole episode was just a little embarrassing. I've been receiving messages from friends, family, readers and the media in the UK commenting and asking me about my new book without having actually seen a copy myself. In the end, out of desperation, I ordered a couple from Amazon. They were with me 5 days later. Now, I'm not suggesting that it is the fault of the Aduana, but I do wonder. If you enjoyed this Twitter, have a look at my website, www.barrymahoney.com, and thank you for listening.